Hi, welcome back to Physics Form 4 KSSM. Today we continue with 2.8 weight. Last time we have discussed about 2.3 free fall motion. So this topic is related to that topic. Okay, now you can refer to your textbook on page 70. Look at the photograph 2.11. The photograph shows a man lifting a barbell. Earth's gravitational pull acting on the barbell contributes to the weight of the barbell. The weight of the barbell makes it difficult for the man to lift it. There is something that opposes the person to lift the load, which is gravitational pull. Okay, the gravitational pull, also known as weight of the load. The barbell will drop to the ground with an acceleration if the man releases it. According to the Newton's second law of motion, I hope you still remember what is stated by Newton's second law of motion. So that is stated by this formula, F equals to ma. So once the object drops, it will fall down with under influence of gravity pull only, meaning we assume there's no air resistance, so free fall motion. So the acceleration of the object is acceleration due to gravity, g. Thus, we get the formula for weight, w, is equivalent to m times g, or the product of mass and acceleration due to gravity, g. So weight is a vector quantity which has the same direction with gravitational force, that is towards the center of the Earth, meaning always downward. The unit used for weight is Newton, because weight is also force. Unit for mass is kilogram. So we have the formula W equals to mg. You rearrange the formula, you get g equals W divided by m. So the unit for g that we get here is Newton kg negative 1. Physical quantity G with Newton kg negative 1 is also known as gravitational field strength. Gravitational field strength G is the force acting per unit mass caused by gravitational pull. For object on the surface of the Earth, gravitational field strength G is 9.81 Newton kg negative 1, meaning each 1 kg of mass experiences a force of 9.81 Newton. Can you calculate your weight on the surface of the Earth? Okay, if you want to calculate your weight, so we just use the formula W equals to mg. Okay, so if you have m, your mass, then g will be gravitational field strength. Thus, we get our weight in Newton. Okay, look at diagram 2.12. Astronaut wearing a full space suit on the moon. Okay, so we have our astronaut, Dr. Sheikh Muzaffar, is the one that first astronaut in Malaysia. Okay, so you can open this one, how astronaut move on the moon. Let's say we want to find mass of the astronaut on the mass of the astronaut on Earth, given is 81.65 kilogram. So we calculate the weight on Earth equivalent to 81.65 kilogram times gravitational field strength 9.81. So we get 800.99 Newton. Gravitational field strength on the moon is 1 over 6 of the gravitational field strength on Earth. Thus, we get weight on the moon is equivalent to 1 divided by 6 times 800.99 Newton. So, we get 133.50 Newton. So, from here, we can see due to a very weak gravitational field on the moon, the weight of the astronaut becomes 1 over 6 from the weight of the person on Earth, meaning the astronaut is lighter on the moon. Okay, that's why they keep floating on the moon due to the weak gravitational field strength. So the formula used for weight is W equals to mg. The g you can define as acceleration due to gravity, 9.81 meters second negative 2. Or you want to define as g equals to gravitational field strength equivalent to 9.81 newton kg to the power negative 1. Okay. So that's the end of the topic 2.8. So you can continue the exercise formative practice 2.8. You can answer all the questions in the exercise book. So if you have any problem, then you can just leave a comment in the Google Classroom so that we can discuss it later. Okay, now we continue with the module. Okay, for topic 2.8 weight. For the module, you can look at page 49. Okay, as usual, the notes given here, you can just read through. We have discussed that weight equals to mg. Okay, and then define W is weight, then m is mass of the object, g is acceleration due to gravity. So for this topic, you must be able to differentiate between weight and mass. As your PJK teacher maybe always ask you to go and weigh your, go and measure your weight, timbang berat. Okay, but in the end you come back with 60 kilogram, 50 kilogram. That one is not weight, that one is mass. Okay, so in physics, weight and mass are two different physical quantities. So you must be able to differentiate between the two physical quantities. Okay, number two. Weight of the object changes when it is placed in areas with different gravitational field, meaning different gravitational field strength. The gravitational field of Earth is not uniform, causes the weight of an object varies according to location. Because actually, our Earth is not round shape, it's an ellipse shape. So the distance between from the center of the Earth might be different, depends on the location. That one we will discuss more under chapter 3, gravitation. Okay, now we want to differentiate between mass and weight. Okay. Okay, look at the first one, diagram. Complete the table comparison between mass and weight. Look at the definition for mass. Quantity of matter in an object. For weight, is gravitational force acting on the object. So they have different definition for mass and weight. Symbol for mass, we use small m. For weight, we use capital W. For SI unit, mass is kilogram, but weight is Newton. The type of quantity, mass is base quantity or scalar quantity, but weight is vector quantity and also derived quantity. Measuring tool that we use to measure mass is inertial balance or digital balance. For weight, we can use spring balance. So the unit will be given in Newton when we measure using spring balance. Okay. Now look at uji kendiri 2.8, some of the calculation problem regarding this topic. Okay, number one, the gravitational force acting on the object of mass 500 kg is 4000 newton. What is the gravitational field strength? So we use the formula W equals to mg, so g equals to F divided by m. Thus we have force is the weight, 4000 divided by mass 500. Thus we get 8 newton kg negative 1. Meaning the strength, the gravitational strength is 8 newton kg to the power negative 1. Alright, question number 2. Number 2. The diagram shows a stroboscopic photograph of feather and marble dropped from the same height in a vacuum. So stroboscope used to freeze the motion of an object so that we can see the image form at certain time interval. So we have this image recorded. Okay, now based on the diagram, you need to answer question given. Part A. Based on the diagram, A1, compare mass of the feather and the marble. So you write down, mass of the marble is greater than the feather. B, A2, compare the time taken to reach the ground. So the time taken are same, meaning the ball, the marble and the feather will reach the ground at the same time, because in vacuum there's no air resistance. The only one force that acts is gravitational pull. Okay, third one. State how mass affects the time taken to reach the ground. Mass does not affect the time taken to reach the ground. Okay. Name the physics concept to describe the situation. So this one is free fall. Okay. So you want to know whether the mass does affect time taken. So we go back to the formula of linear motion equation that we can use to solve calculation problem. Okay, part B. Sketch a velocity time graph to show the motion of both objects. So the object, both objects will experience free fall because no air resistance. Only gravity pull that act on both objects. And the time taken does not affected by mass. Then, meaning both objects will fall down with same acceleration, that is acceleration due to gravity. Or we can say both objects experience constant acceleration. So for V against the graph, you must remember the shape of the graph. For constant acceleration, so we get a straight line pass through origin. So this one shows that constant acceleration, that is acceleration due to gravity. Okay, but C, name one physical quantity that causes the feather and the marble fall. So you write down gravity pull or gravitational force. Okay, D, what happens if feather and the marble are not dropped in vacuum? Give reason for your answer. Okay, look at the answer given. If we let the two objects fall in air, not in vacuum, of course there will be air resistance. So for the marble and the feather, which one will have larger air resistance? Remember, air resistance is affected by area of contact or the surface area of contact to air. Okay, so we look at the feather has larger surface area contact compared to marble. So we can see the feather will experience larger air resistance compared to marble. So from there we can write down the conclusion. The marble will reach the ground first due to air resistance acting on the marble is smaller. Or we can say that the net force that act on the marble is bigger compared to the feather. Because for the feather, it need to overcome the air resistance. So the net force is smaller. So the marble will reach the ground first compared to feather. Okay, so meaning we have done this topic 2.8. So you can continue, do all the exercise at the end of this chapter 2.